then they sad again, and they're miserable for the rest of the month. I mean, there's 31 plus minus days in the month. Now, can you imagine only being happy for one day? What are you doing with the rest of the days? Right? Because our lives are so put in a little box of just getting paid. We were sharing with the group that we've been journeying with, the young youth group, the other day. We finished now with the course on social media to speak there one time, which was awesome. And we were sharing with them, like, think about it, what is the purpose? You know, one of our big problems currently in SA is youth unemployment. So what is the thing? What about what is the purpose, the original purpose for a job? Because many people think that the original purpose for a job is to get paid. That's not the truth. The original purpose for a job is to work. The result of working equals a salary that comes at the end of the month. The original purpose of a job is not to get paid. But it's to work, to give of yourself away, to serve of yourself away. And by the way, the more effectively you do that, the bigger the money will become at the end of the month. Because if it wants to become great, it must become a servant at the end of the day. And the more effectively you're able to serve, you'll be shocked at how the marketplace actually pays for it. So again, the purpose as to why something actually exists. For me, one of the saddest things in life is, number one, time wasted. And time gets wasted. Why? Because we don't understand the purpose of the world of things. Right? Another one of the saddest things in life is to be alive but to yet not live. There, but you are autopilot, you're like a robot, right? Just going from point A to point B. Wake up, eat, go to work, eat, sleep. Wake up, eat, go to work, eat, sleep. There must be something more. Right? Which leads to this particular point. This is a very important point. Because some people have literally killed themselves because of this. Any success without fulfillment is the ultimate failure. Any success without fulfillment is the ultimate failure. In fact, you cannot label something as success if you're not fulfilled. It can't be labeled as success. Right? And I believe that the Lord is calling us into something deeper, which is what you guys are busy doing. Because I mean, like, to have a business like a little child, right? You have to cultivate it and grow it and build it up and, you know, take care of it and, you know, manage it equity and lead and all these different types of stuff that it takes to grow something successful. Right? But coming back to that premise over there, the second one, which is understanding. Getting the knowledge and then get understanding of it. But that in and of itself is not enough, because how many of you know maybe some dentists, all right, they tell you don't eat chocolates, but as soon as you leave their room, they put out a little flake. You quickly have a little flake. So they got the knowledge, they got the understanding, but they're not doing the piece, which is wisdom. What is wisdom? Wisdom equals applied truth. It equals applied knowledge. We were taught, all right, and I think maybe some of you have heard this word before, this quote before, knowledge is power. That's not the truth. Because again, you can have knowledge but do nothing with it. Right? Knowledge, like the one guy says, knowledge is potential power. Applied knowledge is what makes the difference.